Hey folks, this is Njobl Ulram-blr with a surprise series for you. I'm taking some time off from the channel right now, but I have had time to dive into a few games that I haven't played in a long time. Skyrim is one of my all-time favorite games, and I've been goofing around with it and kind of got the bug. So, there's something that this is one of the reasons I started this channel. Something I wanted to do all along was something that I saw a YouTuber named Briarstone do, where he would jump in with a random start mod on Skyrim, and he would dive in as a character and show up somewhere randomly and play that character out. If the character died, the series ends. So you've got to play it smart. You can't just dive in and tackle things that are way above your pay grade and just, you know, restart over and over again. If this character dies, the series is over. So what I'm going to do with this series is pre-record the whole thing. Get the whole thing done, see how it comes out, and if I like it, then I will release it. I don't know how long it's going to be. I don't know how long I'm going to live. It could be 3 episodes, it could be 30. Don't know. And then depending on the kind of comments that I get back from it, it'll determine whether or not we do more of these, or if this was just a one-time thing that didn't really work. So, I'm going to give this whole thing a test. I tend not to use many mods in any of the games that I play, but I have loaded a few onto here. So we'll look at these real quick. For one, I don't want to have to start with the vanilla start of the game, so we definitely have an alt start mod going. Let's see, if I go to load order, I can see them. So, alternate start. Where is the other? Down here? There we go. Live another life. No, it's actually it's new beginnings. Live another life gives you another group of alternate beginnings. So this will allow you to create a scenario and dive into the game playing that role play. Real interesting mod there. There was another one I was using before that would just randomly dump you out into the world somewhere. And sometimes it worked and it was fun. Sometimes it dropped you right into a dragon's lair. Level 1 player up against a dragon doesn't work. But anyway, also put in reasonable movement speed, because it drives me insane to be following a non-player character and I have to run up to him, then stop and wait, and run up to him, stop and wait. So this matches you to the non-player characters in the game, or them to you, either way. As well as it kind of moderates the speeds, so that, you know, I usually play on stealth in crouch mode instead of just walking, because the walk is too slow and the run is too fast, but crouch is right in between. So this helps to moderate those gaps in between. Let's go to the top here. Ars Metallica goes through the smithing of the game, adds things like the ability to smith arrows, ability to smith lockpicks, and if you're part of a certain guild, it'll allow you to create the armor that belongs to that guild. So this adds a lot to the smithing aspect of the game. True Storms completely redoes the weather of the game, and I've got a subwoofer on my computer here, and when I'm playing by myself and have the stereo cranked up, the sound, when thunder slams into you, it shakes the walls. I mean, they did a very good job with the sound effects and with the visuals of it. The only thing I don't like about this is when fog hits, it is dense. It's Thule fog. It's fog like you see in South Central California, where it comes in so thick you can't see 10 feet in front of you. That kind of fog. And it pretty much renders you useless. You can't see that wolf that's behind the tree, you know, 3 trees in front of you. So that makes it difficult. Immersive Citizens goes through and overhauls the AI of all of the non-player characters. Gives them more realistic behaviors. When they are outmatched, they will flee. When it's raining out, they will seek cover. If they are part of a family, they will all have a meal together at some point during the day. They have time off scheduled at certain parts of the day, and they have a list of things they can do, from just going out and taking a walk to picking flowers to Dell, you name it, all kinds of options. So it really makes the environment that you're playing this game in more real. And bandoliers is something that I saw in one of Night Ghost's playthroughs of Skyrim. He's got several series of these videos too, that allows you to create bags and pouches that increases your carry weight. So you don't have to put all of your points into stamina just so you can carry something without having to have a follower with you. It allows you to make it a little bit easier to pull that off. So I hit them all. I don't have that many, but I think that's all of them. Back and back. So let's dive into a new game. That didn't take. Try it again. There we go. New game. And we're basically going to get to create a character without having to go through the vanilla start of the game. I'm not going to do much in the way of character creation this time. Next series, if we want to continue this, and if I don't get a lot of folks that are new to the channel that have played, 5,000 hours of Skyrim and they're critical of everything that I do, which kind of makes it no longer fun to make videos. If we get some nice comments and it just stays calm and peaceful and everyone's having a good time, then we'll do this again. In which case, I'll spend the first episode just creating the character and coming up with a backstory and come up with a reason to even be playing the game. Let's just go with a Nord. We'll just leave him just like he is. Like I said, next time we'll do this for real. So, name him. I did find a Nord name generator online and scoured that for a while, found some options, tortured them big time, and came up with this one. You tell me what you think. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. I'll let you pronounce that. All right, accept. And here's where this mod comes in. Basically, we head over to the Mara statue, and this
approach,
gives us,
my child, and choose where your new life shall begin.
All of the different options to start off for a role-playing adventure in Skyrim. You've arrived on board a ship, and there's three cities with ports, so it lets you choose which port. You own property in one of the holds. This lists all the holds that have a house that you can buy. Or it may also deal with the properties from, what's the third DLC that came with this, where you can build a house? I haven't clicked on this one yet. New member of a guild lists all the guilds to choose from. Patron of a local inn. I clicked on this once. The list is extensive. Every tavern in the map is there, I believe. Soldier in an army, so whether you want to be an Imperial or a Stormcloak. Here's the vanilla start. So, caught crossing the border illegally. So that triggers the start of the original game. Want to escape this cell. A few lockpicks will show up in there and off you go. To where? Let's see here. Tab, map, where are we? So we've got an actual jail. Oops, that didn't work. L. What's over here? Is that the Thalmor prison? I can't really zoom in on that. I noticed the names aren't here. So there's Windhelm. There's Riften. And we should have White Run over here. I was wondering if I could see a building there. Nope. Anyway, some kind of a prison over here that we are in. And let's see, let's pull out of this. No, this isn't the Thalmor prison. At least not the same cell. There is a start
approach
here.
Approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall begin.
That has you break out of one. I've tried that. That one's tough. That one's really tough. I mean, yeah, you can break out. You've got nothing. They're all armed. They're all armored. And they wipe you out every time. Only one time did I go running out of there. I didn't even try to fight. I just ran like crazy. I got out. And then they all stopped chasing me like, oh, I guess he's gone. And I thought, ah, that's so unrealistic. They would have chased me down completely. I would have froze out there in the winter landscape, so yeah, didn't want to do that one. What else we have here? I'm an outlaw in the wilds. That probably starts you off as a thief. Now I tend to play more of the paladin character, the noble character. So I won't do magic, I won't do thieves, I won't do criminals. I'll be the one that goes out and takes out the thieves and the magicians and the bandits and criminals. So a lot of these I wouldn't even consider starting. Vigilant of Stendar is more of a, they're going after Daedra, going after probably vampires, and more of a religious-based game. Camping in the Woods, I popped into that one once. It starts you off at a tent and a campfire and a dragon going over the top of you. He takes off, scares you really good, and then you're asked to go discover Helgen. So probably more of the beginning of the Dragonborn scenario. Shipwrecked off a coast. This one tosses you way up north between, oh, somewhere near Daystar, I'm guessing. Dawnstar? Dawnstar. And it's rough, because up there you've got you know, ice wolves and what have you. You get very little armor, very little weaponry, and nowhere to go but just sit there and shiver. So that one's really a survival one. Vampire in a secluded lair, a necromancer, a warlock's thrall. Attacked and left for dead. I'm liking this one. It's tough. You start off with nothing, and you've got to figure it all out. So there are several places that it can dump you. It's not the same every time. Attic in a skooma den. Adventurer in a Dwemer ruin. I haven't clicked on that, but that one scares me. Dwemer ruins are rough. Therefore, when you have gotten quite high in your skill levels and your weaponry and your armor, because there's some tough stuff in these. To start off as a level one character in there, I can't imagine making it through that. Maybe you turn right around and walk out of that ruin. An alchemist camping in the wilderness. I haven't clicked on that, but where is that? I think it's where I have seen that. There's a place near Falkreath, I think, where there's a pond and two, what are the nature, I can't think of the names right now. Anyway, there's an alchemist with a campsite, and he's dead, and you get to read his journal that he went over into that pond and was killed. I wonder if you're going to start off as him. I don't know. I've arrived at Angie's camp. That's near Falkreath as well. So Angie's camp is a place where she teaches you how to shoot bow and arrow and shoot the targets. That's a good start. If you want to be my kind of character, I like to do stealth. I like to do bow and arrow, and probably one-handed. I like the shield. So this one is something that I would consider. Left 4 Dead is something I would consider. And what else? I am a beggar. I haven't clicked on that. I don't know if it'll ask you what city you want to be a beggar at. You probably end up with just rags and maybe a dagger if you're lucky. So that's a tough start there. Attacked by a dragon. Don't know that one. Don't know where it lands you. Been thrown into jail. That's the Thalmor prison. That one's is rough. These two right here, wandering mercenary or wandering merchant traveling into Skyrim, starts you off basically at the entrance of the map from several of the provinces surrounding Skyrim. So you've got enough to get yourself going with these. Pilgrim to a temple. Imprisoned by the Thalmor. Oh, that's Imprisoned by the Thalmor. So this is something different, which is something from Breakout of Prison. So there's three different prison ones. Interesting. I've not clicked on all but just this one right here. Vampire. Slain by vampire, laid to rest. Warlock, a werewolf, pilgrim. Eric the Slayer's childhood friend. I think that starts you off with a follower. I guess what that's about. And surprise me, completely random start. So I'm going to go to the Left 4 Dead. Where did you go? Right there.
The light of hope shines even for you. Don't give up.
And head over to the bed. And that triggers the beginning of the game. Now that's starting me off in the full run position. I've noticed something with Skyrim. Whenever you transition out of a scene, it quite often changes whether or not you are walking or sprinting or running when you press the WASD. So I found, in case you've fought that too and wondered how to fix it, if you hit the caps lock tab, just like that, it'll reverse it. So that'll get me back to walking. I like to walk and then hold the shift down when I'm ready to run. That way it feels a little more natural walking around. You're not always in a running mode. I like to play the game as natural and realistic as I can. You know, I would probably walk over and shake this door a bit. Nobody responds to my pounding on the door to see what's going on here. Anyway, so let's go see where we might be left for dead and see what's going to happen here. Oh, my head. Man, what hit me? Where am I? I suddenly have amnesia. That's it. Whoa. Okay. Well, let's drop into sneak here, crouch, and kind of look around. Don't see any movement that way. Looks quiet over there. So, we don't have much to our name now, do we? So, where are we? Okay. Windhelm and Riften. Okay, so we're kind of where we were in the same area as that prison, which was, what, there? I'm thinking there. Anyway, we apparently were riding on this wagon and something big enough to make that his puppy dog broke it. You ever been hit by a giant? I have once. They hit you with a club as long as you are, and it sends you into the clouds. And then you slowly plummet to earth. Slam! And that's the end. So, I have avoided giants ever since. You don't need to test me twice on that one. Nothing out here that wants to bite us, right? Okay, well, let's see what we've got. Well, what do we have on us? Items. All. That's all. Potatoes we just picked up, some apples, miner's clothes and boots, no weapons, no armor. Wow. And if we were to look at skills, pretty much 15's all about. Extra in speech, light armor, one-handed, two-handed block, smithing. Pretty neutral character. Okay. So we've seen where we are, we've seen what we don't have. What is in our immediate vicinity? Got a book down there, dead horse. Oh, who are you? A Khajiit. Could this have been a merchant wagon? Khajiit. Things to sell. Killed. And I maybe was hitching a ride with him? Don't know what the backstory is on this one. But you've got some armor on. I could really use that. And a steel sword. Ooh. And a lockpick. A lockpick. Yeah. Let's grab all that. And let's put it on. Weapons. Yes. Favorite. Apparel. Grab you guys. Gives us 39 for an armor rating. Good. Alright, steel sword, you are my new number one. And let's set that one right now. Okay, so we're still in sneak mode. Nothing knows we're here yet. Any chance there's some horse hide over here? No, just meat. And for the weight, it's not worth it. Okay. Sack of cabbage, sure. Juniper berries. A chest with an adept lock. Let's grab all the books and something to sell later. Not much weight. Not worth a lot, but that was 1 pound for 5 value. That's usually what I use as a minimum. 1 for 5. when I decide whether I want to carry it around or not. Then after I fill up, I shift to 1 for 10. Knapsack. Ooh, minor healing. We might need that. Otherwise, nothing else that's going to help us here. Grab it all. And let's set this to favorite. And that is number 7. I saved my life slot, number 7. Got a chest here. Can't do anything with this. That's just for show. Oh, one more book. Something to sell. Now, can we do this with one pick? Been a while since I've gotten a lot of practice at this. So let's see where it is. Is it centered? Ooh, that's a good start. Where do we tap? Well, that was nice. Thank you, Skyrim. What do we have here? Iron gauntlets. That's going to help out. Quite a bit of gold. Another healing. Good. Scroll of Mayhem. Creatures and people up to level 12 will attack anyone nearby. What if I'm the only one nearby? I'll take all these. We'll take things even that we're not going to use right now, because it would be great to be able to sell them. Some of them are not worth much, but when you don't have anything, a little is worth much. There is the mammoth. I don't see the giant yet. There he is, over by the fire, warming up. I just had the urge to look over to my right side over there to see what temperature it is, like it was Rimworld. Alright, so what's the plan? Still nothing around. It looks like it wants to eat me. So, a safe place to sit back and just kind of figure things out. Where do we want to go? I'm curious if that was a real jail or if that was just part of a mod. Want to venture over there, I think. We got Riften. Den of Thieves. Thieves Guild. Everyone wants to kill you. We got Windhelm. A lot of angry people. Prejudice. Just kind of makes you sick to your stomach with some of the conversations in there. Although, for a paladin character who wants to save the ones that are oppressed, that would be a good place to go. And if I want to get rid of the Thieves Guild, that'd be a good place to go. Over here, White Run. Fairly happy people. That's why it's a good starting area. This one, what was his name? The Jarl there. Boy, he's full of himself. This is a rough, angry area over here. This is kind of interesting. Let's go here, and we'll figure out the rest after that. I think that's probably the best plan. All right, so I've got everything I can get out of here, all right? Yeah. All right, we're not going that way. I want to head up there. Just looking at my... the compass there at the top of the screen, right near the W. That's a dragon head. That is a dragon lair up there. We're not going there, in case you were curious. Now, whoa. Detected by what? Oh. Mr. Mammoth there. Okay. What we got here? Creeper cluster. Seems like those sold for a decent quantity. Probably have a lot of the... That's you guys, right? It's gotta be. Yeah. Anything over here? Seems like a good place for wolves or saber cats. Ooh. Right there. We got a wolf. Two wolves. And we're gonna need wolf pelts. We're gonna need pelts. Leather. Deer, whatever we can find. To use the bandolier mod. So there is incentive to actually head out there and coax them into trying to eat us. Now, in real world, wolves are actually quite skittish. Very intelligent. They're not going to attack you. They're going to get the heck out of there. So the idea that wolves are going to hunt you down in the woods is just not real. But that's what Skyrim has decided to do. They've made wolves a low-level enemy. So it's one of the first things you go that'll go after you are a pack of wolves. And they'll put quite a few of them out there. The foxes don't hurt you. They run away. It is a saber cat, right? Or something like that. Some name like that. Those things are just, you know, tanks on wheels. Those things will take you out no matter what. Low-level character going after basically a saber-toothed tiger is not the smartest thing to do. All right, now, get out of sneak. Sneak will slow you down, including slow down. Get back here. Slow down your weapon and slow down your ability to back up and all of that. So sneak is not something you want on during the attack. And I'm usually in the sneak, so I've got to remember to get myself out of that. So wolf pelts, deer hides, ram fur or skins or whatever you would call it. I missed that jump. Those are what we want to get while we're trying to find our way out of here. What's in the water? Is that just a skeleton? What's the dark? Oh, it's whatever that bush is there. There's a goat. Or a ram. Wolf right there. So we're heading off in that direction. Let's get up over there. And you are Dragon's Tongue. You ought to be worth 3 or 4 to a merchant. All of these will... Hello. We'll add up. There's another one. I don't know if I really want to run them down. If I stick to wolves, they'll come to me. But all these things will add up and buy us a bow or something later. That water has got to be hot. Boy, those are tough goats. Okay, dragon up there. Oh, I'm not in sneak mode. I usually am. I'd like to see... That wolf is standing up on his hind legs. That is a wolf, right? Yeah. Deer. Running from what? A fox running from what? Normally it's something like a wolf or a big angry cat that chases it. Yeah, there's something here. Hate when that happens. You're sneaking up on something, and you have no idea what it is. Is it simply a deer? Or is there something with canines? Or worse, grizzly claws? Well, we're kind of going in the right direction anyway. Let's go over the top of this hill. See what's going on here. Now, first episode of this series, maybe even second episode, it's not going to be all that thrilling, because if I die, the series is over. There's a deer. He's spooked. Ah, missed. Nope. Too far away. If I die, series is over. So I'm not going to be doing anything tremendously heroic. That's for sure. I mean, level 1 character is basically a wimp. But, though if I had a bow, that'd be different. You can get yourself way up on a hill and take out your enemy, or a Kelkum, okay? Take out your enemies from there. You can do so much more as a level 1 archer than you can a level 1 swordsman. Especially without a shield. Block at least a little bit of the damage and do some shield bashing and knock them backward a little bit. And at least live a little bit longer. Yeah, if I had a bow, I might go after him, but me chasing a deer, that's not how I want to spend the next 15 minutes. So we're going that way. We've got a water wheel, a sawmill that way. Another mammoth, another giant's area. Cave. Now there is a mod. I was choosing between, that one I showed you that deals with walking speeds. with the non-player characters. There's another one out there, I don't remember the name now, that, in case you're wondering, this is where the dragons are buried, dragon burial mounds, that goes way beyond what I described. It doesn't just moderate your walking speeds and their walking speeds, but it goes through and changes stuff all through the game. I got myself distracted trying to remember what I was talking about. One thing it changes is distances. You won't see all those symbols unless you are actually within a line of sight of it, of them. So you don't get all of the stuff scattered all through your compass up above. Only as you get closer to it. Something detected me. Something up on the hill? Probably be a good idea to have that out. Hello? I'm right here. There you are. One, two. One, two. Okay. What else? Be nice if they chase a deer or something. Kind of get their earnings. Three. Am I ready for three? Too bad you can't lure one out of the pack. Doesn't really give you the ability to do that. Once one comes at you, they all do. Okay, if I were to go off to the side, kind of. There we go. And I'm backing up in my chair and ducking and this would be kind of interesting with a face cam, huh? I am all over the place. I am fighting that battle inside. Alright, so what else is around here before I just go traipsing off? We're going that way. Can I make that jump? I think I can. There we go. That other mod, again, I don't know the name. If I think of it, I'll flash it up on the screen. Hello. You're doing some surfing there. It also changes the heights that you can jump. Makes it so that you're not able to drop quite as far as vanilla Skyrim without getting injured. Because you can jump an insane distance in this game. And it never felt real. So it adds a lot of realism. There's a giant down there. Yeah. These guys are interesting to walk next to and watch. But not this time. Alright, so we're going this way. That was really a good start. Starting off with that wagon and that Khajiit there. Normally when I start this thing... Now, there is one that starts you off in a cabin. But for the most part, you've got nothing. I got it all. It didn't disappear. Yeah, it doesn't disappear. Okay. So normally you end up with nothing and you're really just trying to scrounge berries, you know, whatever you can to find a place to sell it and maybe earn a bow and get started. What is out there? Looks like a tent of some kind. Don't know. Where are we at now? Alright, so we want to continue heading due west and then find a place to cross this river. We're heading toward water here, so we're going kind of that way to that fort, which can't be good for a level 1 character. What is out here? Is this a hunter? Or is this something that I'm going to wish I hadn't gotten involved with? Level 1 sneak. There's somebody over there, I think. That's probably who we're sneaking up on, but let's just pause a second and verify that. Anything in the woods over there? Boy, that looks like a bear. What is that at the top of my little indicator. Maybe it's a boulder and the grass looks like legs? I don't know. I don't think I want to find out. Can I outrun a bear before my... well, my stamina will go down immediately. Here I am getting closer to find out. Okay. It may be I'm sneaking up on this tent and that's what's seeing me. Nothing else is obvious here. I want to see if that's a hunter. I'm detected by something. I don't see anybody over there. Huh. Okay. What sees me? I don't know how many times I've spent... whoa, that rumble. A lot of seismic activity out here. What all the steam vents are about. Everything's kind of rumbling and earthquakes. No, I don't see anybody around. And I'm not going to get to him because I would imagine that water's boiling hot. To get to him, I have to go over there anyway. So let's go over there. What are you? Corundum ore. I'm trying to remember. That's what you make steel out of in this game, right? Okay, we are doing some... definite sneaking up on something. Where was that giant? No, we're out of his point of view, right? Was it that simple? Giant, you're over there somewhere. I know that's not it. Okay. Well, if I keep this up, I might actually get to level 2 just on sneak advancements. There is a lot of mist in the background. But I think we saw that in the map. This whole area here looks misty. I don't know if it's just the clouds or if that's like sand or what. I'd be curious to see if we get the same mistiness over here. But it's just like a fog of war out there. Not quite used to that. Maybe the true storms adds that to it. Okay, giant, you're off in that direction somewhere. There's nothing over here. Got a bridge over there. That'll help us get over to the other side where that prison may be. Not sure where we're going to end this episode. We're going to get to that prison and call it done, or just what? I don't think I want to go in. That doesn't sound like a wise move. I got out of there, thankfully. Detected, hidden. Getting close to that tent again, right? Ooh, almost level 2. But I still don't know what sees me. Giant's too far away. There was a person by the tent. I sure didn't see him. Wait a minute, there's something in the water? Is this what I think it is? I came across this once a long time ago, and I could not believe what I was seeing. Let's sneak over, you know, walk over this side. A bunch of town folk just kind of came over here to jump in the hot springs. Hello?
Yes?
Hunters. Okay. You're just reclining in the water here. I'm going to take a peek at your book if you don't mind. Ooh, smithing. We'll leave that behind. Alright, no stealing from you. There's your clothes over there. And your sword. If I was an evil character, I could so take advantage of this situation. Anyway, let's hop out of here. Oh, I got a level, didn't I? Let's talk about that. park ourselves right over here. Where's that bridge? Right over there. Anyway, level up. What have we got? I usually start with health and just go back and forth with health and stamina for a while. If I use any magic at all, it would be maybe for healing. Or there was one that lets you see, I can't think of what it's called now, life force of anything living around you. So let loose on that one. It'll give you a glow of an aura somewhere off in the distance. You can see that something's around. Otherwise, I don't really dabble in magic much in this game. Let's grab health for now, because we could use it. And while I want to get into archery when we get the bow, we'll wait for that. Sneak is really important. One-handed, though, would also be quite helpful. Don't have a shield. Let's talk about block. Art of blocking enemies' blows, shield, or weapon. You know what I don't know? I know that when I've got a bow, I can, right-click it, and it'll bang him in the head with the bow if you're close enough. But does that only happen after you've got your first level of block? I don't remember. So you usually get one of each here real quick. Let's go with sneak. That could well keep us alive. Alright. So, level 2, we've got sneak going. And let's... Let's figure out where that bridge goes and work our way over to there. And see if this fog goes away when we do that. So the bridge is over there. So let me think about that again. Bridge is in front of me. Okay, it's going to cross here apparently. Can I zoom in over there? Kind of. What is the round right there? Leave it. Around there and there. A lot of little things in here. So I can get across and then head up probably along the shoreline and work our way in. And what was that noise? Nothing. Anyway, sneak. There we go. Oh, I'm going so slow because it reversed my my walk and run. Okay. Hello, I'll take that. I usually don't do a lot of running in Skyrim. I just take my time and enjoy it. So we're heading into that land over there against that keep. I do just enjoy walking around in this game and exploring, so I'm never in a hurry. I don't worry about trying to get somewhere too fast. I rarely use fast travel. How am I going to get over there? That's still a problem. That is still a problem. Yeah, that bridge goes from there to there. Interesting. So I guess I got to get down to this area. Okay. There are mods that you can get for Skyrim that are survival mods. If you get wet, you get cold. You know, hypothermia. You've got to eat or your calories run low. What are you? Just a skeleton or a skull. Okay. Got to drink water. You got to stay warm. Different materials give you different qualities of warmth. This feels so slow. That's because that mod that dealt with the walking speed slowed down the... I'm kind of a little too high here. Slowed down the sneak. That's a shame. Anyway, you can light campfires to warm yourself up. There's lots of different survival aspects that are added to the game with those kind of mods. I used to use those, and it got to where I was spending all my time playing Survivor Man instead of playing Skyrim. So I got rid of those. They were interesting. If I wanted to play a game in this environment, but as a survival game, then I'd probably load this back in. But with the just wanting to get out here and you know, take out some bandits, then I didn't want to spend so much time trying to find calories, trying to find warmth. Especially when random starts can start you off out in the middle of the mountains. But doesn't take into account what you would have had on going into those mountains already. You're not going to head out into the mountains, get all the way to the top in rags, and suddenly you find yourself cold. Dark water crossing. You know, so it doesn't really help the realism. Dark water crossing. Seems like there's a tavern or something associated with that name. What are you? Oh, yes, I was right. There is something here. Let's peek in here and... yeah, this is a friendly place. Stormcloak place, right? Yeah, let's say hi.
Disrespect the law and you disrespect me.
Okay. I will stay away from him. Yeah, we've got a mine... like a family. Where the miners stay over here. Some fish hanging, smoking, or drying. Don't know if I can do any trading here. I'll say hi to you.
I used to be an adventurer in my day.
Really?
And I settled down, got married.
Tell me more.
That's right. I used to explore all over. I'm the one who originally found the mine Darkwater Crossing was built around. I was actually scouting a bit the other day, old time's sake. Spied a brigand heading back to his camp.
Hmm.
Up for a little hunting? My husband is being a sad stick, so I can't go myself.
Sure, I'll do it for you.
This brings back memories. Come back when you're done, and maybe I'll be up to showing you a few tricks.
Okay.
Bandits are cowards. Don't strain yourself chasing them all down.
So apparently she's got the ability to help me skill up. Okay. So what was that? Let's go to journal. Oh, we already have some quests. I didn't even think of looking here. Oh, my head. So this is waking up there at Steamcrag Camp. I should have known better than to... be wandering around alone like this. Bandits attacked out of nowhere. I've lost everything I've ever owned, and all because of some stupid rumors. I should have waited for Alexius to hire those mercenaries instead. I have no idea where I've ended up or how far from the nearest safe haven I may be, but I certainly can't stay here. Begin your new life. Uh-huh. And she just asked us to take out the leader of the Utering Hills camp. Don't know if we're going to get to that immediately. I still want to head over and check out that that prison that we started off on, or at. Yeah, we kind of know what you're going to say. Who are you?
I keep hearing stories about Morrowind. Sounds like a wretched place.
You look like you come from there, though. Yeah, I don't think I really want to get into the...
safe travel.
Conversations here. I was hoping somebody would want to trade, but doesn't look that way. So let's just move on. Leave these folks alone and we'll come back. Where was that bandit gang we need to take out? Okay. I thought it would be nearby. I did trigger it, right? Well, let's go back into there. I did. Ah, I didn't that one, though. I just did the main category. Now, if you hold your mouse over this guy and hit M for map, it'll take you right to the spot. So that is closer to Windhelm. Okay. And... the direction of Windhelm, I usually don't go. I don't spend a lot of time up in here. These guys right here, Dawnstar and Winterhold. It's just cold looking at it. I just, maybe in the summertime I'll want to do these, but not right now. Anyway, so that is that one, and that is definitely a something to do when we're a little bit stronger. Let's continue our way across the bridge here and across this bridge there and see what this is. That's probably going to be the end of this episode. Now, try to get my bearings here. I did see another bridge, right? was here. Oh, come on now. How do we get into here? No, it was on the other side. I could see this rooftop from where I'm trying to get back to. Ugh. Okay. I'm stuck. Gotta go the long way. There's a guard. Ah, here's the path. So the bridge is out this way. Wasn't much of a path either. There it is. So that crosses our river. And I don't know what is breathing on the other side of the river. So let's head over this way. Boy, I wish I had a bow. I really want a bow. Now, finding a fox in front of you is a good sign. That's something you want. Follow the fox. If anything is going to eat you, it's going to eat him first. Got a road sign over here. What have we got? Ooh, pretty. Whiterun, Riften, Windhelm, Sneak. Where'd the fox go? Fox is alive, so we know it's safe up that way. Oh, oh, oh. I thought I saw something right there. But it's not. So up there is safe. And right through here is safe. What was that last one? Iverstead. Okay, I was thinking another one, and those letters weren't making any sense. Who saw me? I don't know. We want to go this way, right? Yeah. Let's go this way and see if that triggers again. If not, then we'll just keep going. Still a lot of fog in the distance, but much prettier scenery now. I prefer to be up there. I don't think I can get there right now. There's the other bridge. Can I? I think I can. Nope, not gonna let me up. Okay. I prefer to be off to the side, not on the main route, looking down on the trail. So I am going up this way. That's just the sneak I am. What is that down there? No, don't know. What are you? You're rocks. This is a trail, isn't it? Kind of looks like one. Well, there's our bridge. Grab some snowberries here. That drops into that keep right there. Dead wolf. Two dead wolves. Did someone walk by that I missed? No. Well, there's no longer a threat over here. I'll take the wolf pelts. Thank you. No arrows, so you didn't use a bow to take them out. Huh. Well, don't know what to say about that. Good fortune. This is quite a waterfall here. And I can never get onto the sides of the bridges. Wow. Okay. Now, this is trouble. We want to sneak around this. We're not capable. Not skilled up. With a bow, I could get up on the rock there and shoot into it and maybe take somebody out, but not with a steel sword and no shield and no skills and very little health. And on permadeath, rain. Hey, the rain just started. Hello, that's a mage. That mage would love to shoot fire at me. So that must be a mage or conjurer type group that has taken that area. We're going to stay away from them. We have a cave coming up on us, and we're trying to get to there. How far away are we? Kind of heading at it. I was going to follow the water, but that keep stopped me from that. Let me zoom in there. As far as I'm going to go. I was wondering if I could see the keep. So we crossed there and came up this way, right? Is that the keep? I don't know. No, it's closer to us than that. This cave is close, too. Maybe we can get close enough to discover it and get it just placed onto the map without getting seen. That's the challenge. The cave is right there. Don't see any body over there. Waterfall. There are a few waterfalls in this game that have a secret space behind it. Ooh, thunder, lightning. What is that thing? Do I want to know? I don't. Those are spikes with bodies hanging on them. Yeah, that says level 1 character, please come over here. We want to talk to you. Yeah, we're going this way. Sneak increased. Maybe these guys? Maybe the mages. That may be it. Ah, right there. So our sneak got the 1 point in it, and it's enough to have gotten us past those guys. That must be the pathway into that cave. Okay, so we're still trying to go this way. We'll follow the road around. Though I prefer to follow the road from a little bit higher up, so I can see what's going on. Can't quite get up there. Up! There we go. I can see what's coming up ahead of me. I can plan for it. Oh, thunder's getting closer. Okay, so what's down here? Got a crossroad. No movement. Oh, it's kind of a dark, ominous late afternoon. The rain does look a lot better. You can see the individual drops coming down, as well as the mist of all the rain in the background. We've got the sounds of rain. I don't know if you can hear it as well as I can. Kind of pitter-pattering in stereo all around me. Real nice. I'm going that way. I don't see any movement. Okay, anything up the road? Looking good that way. Let's go to those rocks. Oh, no. Just wildflowers. No problem. Let's get up here. Get over to where I think that jail was. And then we call this one done. I didn't set a timer for this. I have no idea how long this episode is. Figured I'd just go till it felt right. I think that jail would be the good. What was that? Something just moved on my desk. That's it there. I remember that. This is the river that comes out of... Let me grab my map. Let's go up over here. Okay. Yeah. Go back into crouch map. This pathway out of Windhelm that you take on your way to Whiterun. I remember coming across this jail before. It's haunted. There are ghosts inside. There are ghost prisoners and ghost guards. And wow, look at that. Look at the detail in this map of those little hidden things. And so that's a tough spot to get out of, or in and out of. They're quite leveled up. So you don't just go traipsing in there. I've never successfully taken that place. Even as a higher level character, when I've come back, they still, you know, you've got to be really persistent. At least be able to take it without dying, let's put it that way. I know this isn't the best place to be in a lightning storm, but I'm going to call this one done right here. And next time, I know there's a chest hiding up there, so maybe next time we'll catch that and then figure out where we're going to go next. Probably Whiterun. Sell off everything we've got, get a bow, and there's usually some Khajiit traders outside of the city over there. Maybe they've got something interesting. Hello! I didn't see you. Oh, I did. That's the one where the mages are. Okay, the conjurers. Yep, let's call this one done here, and I will catch you next time, folks. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.